felt that I was literally standing on a plateau somewhere out there in space, a plateau that science and technology had allowed me to get to. But now what I was seeing, and even more important, what I was feeling at that moment in time, science and technology had no answers for. Literally no answers, because there I was, and there you are. There you are, the Earth, dynamic, overwhelming. And I felt that the world was just, there's too much purpose, too much logic. It was just too beautiful to have happened by accident. There has to be somebody bigger than you and bigger than me. And I mean this in a spiritual sense, not a religious sense. There has to be a creator of the universe who stands above the religions that we ourselves create to govern our lives.
I think if you do something that's drastically different, like flying to the moon and coming back again, everyone tells you how important it is, how wonderful it is, and how important, then by comparison, a lot of other things that used to seem important don't seem quite as much so. And I'm not saying that I'm able to face life with greater equanimity because I've flown to the moon, but I try to. And maybe some of our terrestrial squabbles don't seem as important after having flown to the moon than they did before.
We learned a lot about the moon, but what we really learned was about the Earth. The fact that just from the distance of the moon, you can put your thumb up and you can hide the Earth behind your thumb. Everything that you have ever known, your loved ones, your business, the problems of the Earth itself, all behind your thumb. And how insignificant we really all are. But then how fortunate we are to have this body and to be able to enjoy living here amongst the beauty of the Earth itself.
It truly is an oasis, and we don't take very good care of it. And I think the elevation of that awareness is a real contribution to, you know, saving the Earth, if you will.
Earth has changed a lot since we started flying in Gemini. There's a lot of things like urban pollution, and you can see that when you hit orbit now. You can see the big cities all have their own set of unique atmospheres. They really do. We ought to be looking out for our kids and our grandkids. And what are we worried about? The price of a gallon of gasoline. You know, in the United States, they're worried about $3 a gallon gas. They said, that's awful. You know?
Since that time, I have not complained about the weather one single time. I'm glad there is weather. I've not complained about traffic. I'm glad there's people around. One of the things that I did when I got home, I went down to shopping centers and I'd just go around there, get an ice cream cone or something, and just watch the people go by and think, boy, we're lucky to be here. Why do people complain about the Earth? We are living in the Garden of Eden.
As I look back, if I used one word, I would use the word luck. I just feel very lucky. You know, Neil Armstrong was born in 1930. Buzz Aldrin was born in 1930. Mike Collins was born in 1930. I mean, how lucky can you get? We just happened to along at the right time.
I feel blessed every single day. Not a day goes by that I don't think, this is great. This was wonderful. Somebody had to go, and they happened to pick me. So it was great. You know, some of the tabloids are saying that that we did this in a hangar in Arizona. Maybe that would have been a good idea.
I don't know how I would grab someone by the collar who didn't believe and shake them and somehow change their mind.
Any significant event in history, somebody's had a conspiracy theory one way or the other.
I don't know two Americans who have a fantastic secret without one of them blurting it out to the press. Can you imagine thousands of people able to keep this secret?
We've been to the moon 9 times. I mean, why did we fake it 9 times if we faked it?
Truth needs no defense. Nobody can ever take those footsteps I made on the surface of the moon away from me.